या बिल्कुल।
All right, so welcome to the open finals of Atulya Khel, a sports quiz presented by TACON. Station with Gyan Space, we have six brilliant participants with us. At participant number one, we have Venki Srinivasan. At two, we have Manisha Chhut. At three, we have Shumantro. At four, we have Gokul. At five, we have Aditya. And at six, we have Kinshuk. But let's take a look at the rules of this particular quiz. So four rounds. Round one is called straight bat, six dry questions clockwise. Round two is called third umpire, six questions all based on visual clockwise. Round three is middle overs, six questions anti-clockwise, that's a dry round. And round four is slog overs, six connect questions, so visual connect questions, anti-clockwise. So we'll start off with round number one, straight bat, 10 points for each correct answer. Let's go to Venki for the first question. Question number one, coming up on your screen right now. Okay, question number one is, last 10 games played, India 6-4, Sri Lanka 7-3. Last 10 games, India in Sri Lanka 4-4-2. Last 10 games, India in Sri Lanka 7-1-2. Key players, Tendulkar, Ganguly, Dravid, Vaz, Murali. All this data and a costume led to which nickname? Of course, I also need whose nickname is being talked about. No part of this one. I need both parts. So, whose nickname and what nickname? Am I talking about? Question to Venki. Can you unmute yourself, Venki?
Yeah. Okay, I'll make a guess. I will say these all sound, these all look like, you know, while this is obviously cricket, these all look like football type formation, scores, etc. So I will say that the nickname is maybe Sir Alex or, you know, Alex Ferguson or something to that effect. And I will say whose nickname I will say is John Wright.
Okay. Alex and John Wright. Okay. Manish?
The name of the Lankan Premier League winners, something, something footballers.
No.
Colombo footballers.
Okay. No. Shumantro?
I'll guess Kuldeep Yadav and Charles, properly, maybe they were.
Not Kulcha, Gokul.
Since I don't have anything better, I'll just randomly guess Billy Bowden for the whose nickname part and pass for the nickname.
Okay, Aditya?
No, I'm passing.
Okay, Kinshuk.
Mystery spinner. Mystery bowler.
No, none of them are correct. So these records of India vs Sri Lanka in Sri Lanka last 10 games. Let's take a look at the answer. The costume was also a clue. Let's just go to the next slide and let's take a look at the answer. This is Professor and Dean Jones. You can see the data on the blackboard which he presented and the costume of Dean Jones. This was during the 2004 Asia Cup. This is how Professor came to Dean Jones.
Very nice, very nice.
So, Venki, next question again comes back to you. Okay, question number two to Venki. The company came to the attention of sports followers in Great Britain when Mercedes Lightsey swam the English Channel. Even after the swim, the oyster from this company was in perfect working order. Name this company, perhaps more famous for its association with another event. Should be pretty simple. Which company?
This is Rolex, more famous for its association with Wimbledon, where it has its own.
Absolutely correct. This is indeed Rolex, the Rolex Oyster, first made famous by Mercedes Lightsey, the first English woman to swim the English Channel. Absolutely correct. So 10 points to Venki. You can go to the answer slide. This is Rolex. Shumantro. So now let's question to Manish. Manish, your question. Four golfers have achieved a certain feat at the Augusta Masters. The first to achieve the feat went on to win the tournament in a playoff. This probably remains the most famous occurrence. The second finished tied for 10th. The third finished tied 50th. While the fourth, who achieved the feat in 2012, lost in a playoff. What rare feat is being talked about? What rare feat has been talked about, which has been achieved by four golfers at the Augusta Masters?
This is hole in one.
Hole in one. Okay, can't give you points for hole in one, Shumantro.
This is right. Okay, the people who have achieved a hole in one who have gone on to win the Augusta, right?
No, otherwise I would have given points to Manish in one. Next we have Gokul.
So a hole in one, but on a hole which had a certain limit, which was higher than 3, say 5 or something like that. So which would also be an albatross or whatever. And
absolutely, albatross is what I was looking for. That's the key word, albatross. So these are the four people to have achieved the albatross. Let's take a look at the names. Well done. So 10 points to you, Gokul. So Gene Sarazen, of course, is the most famous occurrence. Then Bruce Devlin, then Jeff Maggart, and the latest, Louis Oosthuizen, in a playoff to Bubba Watson. So well done.
Hey, just out of curiosity, what's actually a difference between albatross and hole-in-one?
No, hole-in-one is you are hitting directly from, you know, your first shot. So albatross happens when, say, on a par 5, you are hitting the same shot you are holding it on a par 5. So Louis Oosthuizen did not hit a hole-in-one. He actually hit an albatross. So on the second shot, he got it directly into the hole. So albatross was the key word that I was looking for. That's 3 under par for that particular hole. Going to Aditya for the next question, coming up on stream now. The first person to win the Olympic gold in the epic works category was Ferenc Menzo. He served as the Secretary General of the Hungarian Olympic Society and in 1956 published a work titled The Modern Olympic Games. For what work did he get the Olympic gold medal in 1928? This is for Aditya. Guys, make your hands visible on screen. Yeah. Aditya?
No, I'm not. I don't have a clue now.
Okay, Kingshuk?
I think he won it for the art competition, 1928. Yes.
But for what work?
1928, he designed the Olympic logo. The rings.
No, not Olympic logo, Venki.
I think he won it for the design of the stadium itself in which the Olympics was held in 1928.
Ah, yes. No. Manish, that's a different person. Manish?
Did he design the atomium?
Not the atomium, interesting. Shumantra?
He designed created the Olympic Charter?
No. Gokul?
Yes, Olympic oath.
No, so epic works in this case refer to literature, and he actually wrote the history of the Olympic Games. So it's one of the first famous histories of the Olympic Games. This is Ferenc Menzo. That's why it was epic works category. It was not related to sculpture, or it was related to literature. It was under subcategory. So this question was for Aditya. So the question comes back to you, Aditya. Question number 5 to you. Shisho Kanakuri won the trials in Japan for the 1912 Olympics with the timing of 2 hours 32 minutes 45 seconds. However, when he arrived in Stockholm, he had to take care of his teammate Yahiko, who was ill. On race day, the temperature was very high as well. However, he collapsed during this event and was taken in by a local family. Unknown to most, he returned to his home country soon after. In 1967, he would return to Stockholm again. Guinness World Record does Shisho Kanakuri hold it. And it is workout, definitely. What record does Shisho Kanakuri hold?
Okay, I'm going to guess that he's the oldest person to complete a marathon.
Oldest person to complete a marathon? No, Kinshu?
I think he has the longest gap or between taking part in the Olympics. 1912 and sort of much later, maybe.
Oh, longest gap between in taking part in the Olympics? No, because 67 there was no Olympics.
No, I mean.
Yeah, Venki.
Okay. I will say that he returned to Stockholm in 1967 in the capacity of possibly as a leader of Japan in some capacity. I don't know whether exactly he was the prime minister.
Not that. Nothing to do with leadership. Manish?
So, because he couldn't finish the race in 1912, he went back to Japan and, you know, felt that he was going to be humiliated and things like that. Then he came back in 1967 and actually completed the remaining part of his whatever was left of the course. So the world record is the longest time taken to finish a particular marathon, which in this case would be some 50 odd years, so on and so forth.
Brilliant answer, Manish. Absolutely correct. This is the longest marathon. 10 points to Manish. Superb answer. 55 years. Yes, let's go to the answer. Yes, he would return to Stockholm in 1967 to complete marathon he had started in 1910. Fantastic answer, Manish. 10 points. Next question to Shumantro. The last question of this round. He received the ball on the edge of the 6-yard box and instead of shooting, opted to drag the ball back, fooling the sliding defender and moved in a different direction in one fluid movement. Visualize the move and tell us what it was called and which legend who represented two countries pioneered this move. Receive the ball on the edge of the 6-yard box and did something. So visualize this move, read the text carefully. Visualize the move and tell us what it was called and which legend who represented two countries pioneered this move. This is for Shumantro.
I will guess Louis Monti for the person.
What's the move called?
Swivel or something.
No? Gopal?
I will guess Puskas for the person and move drag fake.
Okay, passing to Aditya.
I'm going to guess Puskas as well, and the move is called the Elastico.
Okay, King Chuk. Yes, you have to unmute King Chuk. You're on mute.
Sorry. Two different countries you've said, right?
Yeah.
Alfredo Di Stefano.
Okay.
And the Di Stefano drag.
Okay, Becky.
Okay, I will carry on the guess of my learned friend Kinshuk and say Alfredo Di Stefano. And maybe this is the precursor to the Cruyff turn, so it was called the Di Stefano turn because he.
Okay, kind of... nice try, absolutely very nice try. Manish.
That was going to be my answer, what Winky said. So I will try and say Davor Sukar for.
And the move is called?
The Sukar Sucker Punch.
Oh, nice one. No, so no one gets it correct. Dokul. No points for this one because I needed the name of the move. So Puskas is indeed correct. It was called the Puskas V move. So Puskas made a move, very famous. You can check out the video on YouTube. It's called the Ferenc Puskas V move. If you visualize what was going on there, it's like a V. We have one non-com question coming up, as but we don't have audience, but you can all try it. Just unmute yourselves and try it. Let's have the audience question. In 8-ball pool, a player is dashed when it is deemed impossible to strike any part of an on ball by way of a straight line shot. Fill in the blanks with a term that includes the name of another sport. What is this?
Billiard.
Snooker.
Snooker.
Snookered, absolutely snookered. A player is snookered at that point of time, absolutely. Let's go to the next slide and we will move on straight away to the visual round and start again with Shumantro because he had the last question. So we'll again come back to him. Let's go to the first question for Shumantro. This gentleman was selected to be part of the torch relay for the 2012 Olympics. For which iconic Olympic moment do we remember this person?
This is Redmond Senior, the dad who helped his son across to complete the run.
Yes, absolutely correct, Shumantro. 10 points. Quite a simple one for you. Absolutely correct. This is indeed Redmond Senior, the dad who helped his son over the line. And you'll find this round to be a pretty easier round. Let's go to the next slide. Yeah, this is indeed Jim Redmond. Let's move to the next question. This is for Gokul. His team, the person who's in on screen, replaced the Americans as a prominent franchise in a city in a particular professional league. Name the team he founded whose name you would come across many times in a famous TV show. His team replaced the Americans as the prominent franchise in a city in a particular professional league. Name the team he founded whose name you would come across many times in a famous TV show. Yes.
You're saying it's one particular TV show?
Maybe multiple, but in one TV show, this team is mentioned quite often.
New York Yankees.
Not the Yankees, Aditya.
I'm going to guess Anaheim Mighty Ducks.
Not Anaheim Mighty Ducks, Kingshook.
New York Mets.
Not New York Mets, Venky.
New York Knicks and Friends.
New York Knicks is not correct, Manish.
Pass.
Okay, Shumantro.
Montreal Canadiens.
No, I think finally Shumantro hit the right sport.
Oh.
The city, correct? So put New York and ice hockey together, you get the New York Rangers.
Rangers.
Ted Stryker, who was the founder of the New York Rangers. And of course, the TV show is Friends. Let's go to the next slide. Yeah, it is the New York Rangers. Next question back to Gokul. On screen now.
Okay, did Sumatra get points or no points?
No one gets points. Okay, this is for Gokul. This event took place at the ground where a cricket record was set, which India missed equaling by just 10 runs recently. Whose name has been blanked out from the jersey? We have a bigger visual on the next slide. Let's go back to the text. This event took place at a ground where a cricket record was set, which India missed equaling by just 10 runs recently. Whose name has been blanked out from the jersey?
I'll guess Jonah Lomu.
Perfect. It is Jonah Lomu. Absolutely correct, Gokul. This is this was his funeral, and of course at Eden Park, England bowled New Zealand out for 26 runs, and India of course got bowled out 36 for 9. So yes, India missed out by 10 points or 10 runs on equaling that. Yes, Jonah Lomu gets you 10 points, Gokul. Next question to Aditya. This is a 3-time junior world champion. He's the only male to win the junior world championship 3 times in the singles. The only woman to achieve the same feat in the same sport is from the same country as him and has also won the senior world championship. Name her.
Rachana Kintanon.
Rachana Kintanon is absolutely correct. Well done, Aditya. Good answer. This is, of course, Kunlavut Vilitsan, who's also a 3-time world champion, and Rachana also is the 3-time world junior champion, but has also won the senior world championship. Well done, Aditya. 10 points for you. Next question to Kinshu. What was the name of this tournament when this trophy was awarded? We don't have a bigger visual, but just take a look at the slide or the visuals very carefully. What was the name of this tournament when this trophy was awarded? And it's named after an organization. It's named after an organization. I want the name of the tournament when this trophy was awarded. Now it's known as by a different name. But what was the name when this trophy was awarded? Yes, Kinshu. You didn't answer, Kinshu?
Make-A-Wish Open.
Not Make-A-Wish Open, Venki.
So kids there, I'll try UNICEF Open.
Brilliant answer, 10 points. This is the UNICEF Open, absolutely correct. 10 points to you, Venki. Let's take a look at the answer. This is Dmitry Tursunov, who won the US Open. This is Roberta Venci, who won the UNICEF Open. Well done, Venki. 10 points. Very well worked out. Last question of this round to Manish. This is the official program and schedule of what event? The schedule basically doesn't matter. Just take a look at the visual. May 5th to 14th, 1989. All I can say that it happened in Albany, New York, then New York City to Lehi Valley to Harrisburg, Gettysburg, Front Royal, Charlottesville, Richmond, Arlington, Baltimore, Atlantic City. So this is the program and schedule of what event? May 5th to 14th, 1989.
What is the last one, the finish? That's Atlantic City, is it?
Yeah, Atlantic City to Brigantine, New Jersey time trial. Stage finish. Okay. Albany, New York prologue time trial. Stage one, Albany, New York to New Paltz, New York road race. New York City to Lehi Valley road race and all that. Yeah. So what event is this? Manish.
I'm going to guess something like Tour de Airplane.
Not
based on Jefferson
Airplane. Sumantro.
This is the Independence Tour of Independence, like sort of like that.
Not Tour of Chasing Independence. Vocal?
Yeah. Vocal. I think this is organized by Trump. It's called the Tour de Trump, if I'm not wrong.
10 points. It is Tour de Trump. See the visual carefully. This looks like Donald Trump. Absolutely. So Donald Trump decided to come up with his own version of a cycling race. This is Tour de Trump. Fantastic answer. And over to Vishnu for the scores. And we have a non-com question, I think, coming up. Let's do that. Next slide, please. Yeah. Tour de Trump. What has been blanked out? Anyone can answer? Magnificent dash.
Close.
This is dedicated to Miroslav Klose. All right, Vishnu, what is the scores
after round 2? We have team 1, Rinky at 20, team 2, Manish at 10, team 3, Sumant at 10, team 4, Gokul at 30, Aditya at 10, team 5, and team 6, Kinshuk is yet to open his account.
All right, how many minutes we have remaining on the call?
More than 10 minutes.
Then we should proceed.
Yeah.
Okay. Next round is a dry round. We'll start with Kinshuk and Diplock. Yes, Kinshuk, Globus. Third question. This brand borrows its name from the sporting venue where it was first used. On the official website of the brand, Here is how the venue is described. The space race was in full swing. It was a time of palpable optimism, a certain belief that man could conquer the constraints of nature. Ingenuity and forward-thinking progress permitted. The dash was built in the midst of this bullish pursuit of the impossible. What brand is being talked about? A brand which borrowed its name from the sporting venue which I have planned out. What brand is this? And it's more like a generic term nowadays, but it's definitely a brand as well, but it's obviously used as a generic term nowadays.
And don't know, pass.
Passing, okay, Aditya?
Siddharth, you broke off. You said something about generic term. I couldn't.
It's a generic term. It's more like a generic term, but it's definitely a brand as well. It's actually a brand, but it is more used like a generic term. It's like Xerox, for example.
Okay. Oh, okay, I'm going to say Velodrome.
Not Velodrome, Gokul.
Pass.
Passing, Shumantro.
Yeah, Velodrome was my guess. Let me, one second. Colosseum, no. Yeah.
Not Colosseum, Manish?
AstroTurf from Astrodome.
Yeah.
AstroTurf from Astrodome, perfect.
Houston Astrodome.
Yes. Space Age, we talked about the Astrodome. Absolutely correct. 10 points to you, Manish. This is AstroTurf from Astrodome. Next question, direct to Venki. Question 3. This word means an act or remark that is calculated to gain an advantage, especially at the outset of a situation. This word is also the name of an X-Men character that is known to charge cards and other objects with kinetic energy. What is this word that has been in popular consciousness in recent times? Should be easy. Venki, go for it.
This is Gambit of Queen's Gambit.
This is indeed Gambit of Queen's Gambit. Well done, Venki. 10 points to you. And next question to Kinshu. Yeah, question coming up on screen for Kinshu. The Iceman, the Special K, the A-Train, and the Skywalker lost, while the Doctor won. What legendary sporting contest is being talked about? The Iceman.
I'll go with, this is the 4-minute mile, Roger Bannister.
Not the 4-minute mile, Roger Bannister. Aditya?
Pass.
Okay, Gokul?
Yeah, I don't have anything, pass.
Okay, Shumantro?
This is Snooker World Championship.
Not Snooker World Championship. Manish?
This is some F1 race at Monaco or something like that.
Not F1 race at Monaco. Venki?
Is this some one of the all-time great MotoGP races or something? Doctor referring to...
Oh, I did not expect this to come back to me.
One guess. One more guess.
Yes, go
this for it. This is the first All-Star game, the Slam Dunk competition.
Absolutely. It is the first Slam Dunk contest. The doctor was Dr. J. Julius Erving. Let's take a look at the answer. This is the first contest in the ABA, in fact. Dr. J was Julius Erving, George Gerving was the Iceman, the other nicknames were for Larry Kennan, Artis Gilmore, and David Thompson. Next question once again to Kinshu. This country was the first to break the domination of the Soviet Union and Japan in the Women's World Championship by winning it in 1978. From an economic standpoint, when the Soviet Union collapsed, this country fell into recession. as the boundaries opened post the fall of the Iron Curtain, a lot of players from this country began to go abroad to play in professional leagues. However, they were not allowed to play for the national team if they played abroad. This led to a long-term decline in the fortunes of which team in which sport?
Hmm. 1978 women's. I would go with Cuba and volleyball.
Perfect, Kinshuk. 10 points. Cuba and volleyball. Kinshuk gets on the board as well. 10 points. Very well done, Kinshuk. The next question will go to Aditya. This is Cuba and volleyball. Next question to Aditya. This sport does not allow the introduction of elements such as jumps and intricate spins, or such moves as overhead lifts and throw jumps, because they are thought to be inconsistent with the character of dash. Dash is a five-letter word. Lifts are legal, but moves that take the woman over the man's shoulder are not allowed. Limits are placed on the amount of time partners can be separated from each other and how far the distance can be between them. Which Olympic sport is being described here? This is for Aditya. Which Olympics described here? Two-word answer required.
Figure skating.
Not figure skating. Gokul?
Ice dancing.
Ice dancing is indeed correct. These were basically explaining the differences between ice dancing and figure skating. So there are some lifts which are legal in ice dancing, figure skating, but not in ice dancing. Well done. The blanked out word was dance. So Gokul gets 10 points. And next question to Sumantro, the last question of this round. The bronze medalist of the 10 meter platform diving event at the 1920 Antwerp Olympics was led by Duke Kahanamoku to steal something. He did so, folded it and put it in his suitcase. When he finally revealed that he had it, he said he didn't think he would be around for too long. It's not good in a suitcase. I won't be able to hang it up in my room. What did he steal? What did the bronze medalist of the 10 meter platform diving event at the 1920 Antwerp Olympics steal? Based on a dare by Duke Kahanamoku.
This is Weissmuller's Tarzan dress or something.
Not Weissmuller's Tarzan dress, Manish.
Did he steal the Olympic flag?
He did steal the Olympic flag. Well worked out, Manish. Perfect answer. The Antwerp flag was actually missing for 77 years. Before this gentleman finally brought it out. This was Hal Highpriestley, who had the flag for 77 years. And with that, we come to the end of round number 3. We have a non-com question. Let's do that and then we'll take a look at the scores. In the Wisden 100 of greatest ever test bowling performance in 2001, at number 1 was Hugh Tapie.
Bob Willis.
Yes, this is what?
Bob Willis?
Not
eight
Bob Willis.
Eight.
No, not Bob Willis. Which performance is at number?
Jim Lehker.
Not Jim Lehker either.
Spofforth's performance, sir. First ever.
Not Spofforth.
Kumble.
Yes, Kumble. Of course.
Really?
Yes, Kumble's performance is rated the second best performance of all time. Alright, so let's move to the last round of this quiz. Just 6 more questions to go. Let's take a look at the rules. Connect questions, 10 points for correct answer. Starting off with Venki. First question. Connect the 7 people that you see on screen, and it is an exhaustive list. Yes, Venk. unmute yourself.
One sec, just thinking. One second.
Yeah, yeah, sure, sure. No problem.
Max goals in a World Cup tournament and scoring in the final as well.
No, Kingshu.
Golden shoe, golden ball, player of the year, all in the same year.
Golden shoe, golden ball. Same tournament, absolutely correct. Very well done, Kinshuk. 10 points to you. You move on to 20. Let's take a look at the answer. 10 points to you, Kinshuk. Yes, golden ball and golden boot in same year. Sun Wen, Birgit Prince, Marta, Kumari Sawa, Megan Rapinoe, the late Paolo Rossi, and Salvatore Spilacci. So 10 points to you, Kinshuk. Next question to Aditya. Connect. Question to Aditya?
No, pass.
Okay, Gokul.
I have no idea, so I just guess they were both hit for six sixes in an over.
No, Shumatra?
First and current ICC presidents?
No. Manish?
Bob Massey, Narendra Hirwani. 16 wickets untested.
Of course, Manish was not going to miss this. It was an easy one. Bob Massey and Narendra Hirwani. 16 wickets on debut. Well done, Manish. I think Manish moves into a share of the lead. Next question to Venky. Connect.
First and only individual Olympic gold medalist for the respective countries.
Not correct.
Kingshu? These are the people who have, I think, beaten Michael Phelps to his non-golds at the Olympics. The
beaten
teams.
Michael Phelps? No,
the
not beaten
teams
Michael.
And the people.
The teams and people who have beaten Michael Phelps to the Olympic gold, no? Aditya?
Not just team, Baba. People also.
Okay. Aditya?
No, that was my guess as well, but I'm not sure that is Joseph Schooling either, so pass.
Okay, Gokul.
Okay, since it's not beaten Phelps, I'll go with these are the people who finished second to Phelps in his 5 gold medals across 5 Olympics in a particular discipline.
Okay, Sumantra.
No, no more guesses left.
Okay, Manish.
They have not only beaten Phelps, but they also beaten his world record in the Olympics in the same race.
So this was a question to Venky. I'll use my decision and give Gokul 5 points.
This is the 8 medals, the second, I
yes,
think.
This is the 8 gold medals of Phelps in Beijing. But Gokul's yes, second to Phelps across Olympics, in different Olympics also. So, of course, I'll give you 5 points. But what I was looking for specifically is these are Michael Phelps' 8 gold medals in Beijing. These were the silver medalists. Park Tae-hwan, 200-meter freestyle. Milorad Kavik, 100-meter butterfly. Laszlo Shea, 200-meter butterfly, 200-meter medley, and 400-meter medley. France, 4x200-meter freestyle relay. Russia, 4x200-meter freestyle relay. Australia, 4x100-meter medley relay. So, 5 points to Gokul. Next question, I'll go to Shumantra. Question 4. Correct. for Sumantro. Yes, Sumantro.
These are the sporting franchises of Los Angeles.
These are the sporting franchises of Los Angeles. Well worked out, Sumantro. The Artful Dodger, the Kings, the Rams.
Lakers, Rams, Kings.
Clippers gets its name from an old team. So 10 points for Sumantro. Two more questions to go. Move on to Manish. Manish, your question. Okay, finished.
Is this an exhaustive list or something?
No.
No. These are what you see on the logos of the ISL teams.
Not correct, Venky.
These are the team names in the in that new proposed Aussie rules football league that is trying to come to India.
Not correct. Okay.
These are shots in Q Sports, English, Bank, Anchor, Train, Diamond, Canon.
Brilliant answer, absolutely correct. Terms used in Q Sports, English, Rail, Diamond, Canon, Anchor, Bank. Fantastic answer, Kinshuk. 10 points to you. Let's take a look at the scores with just one question to go.
Yeah, team team 1, Winky is at 30. Manish is at 40. Team 3, Suman is at 20. Kokul team 4 is at 45, Aditya team 5 is at 10, Kinshuk team 6 is at 20.
Is it 30?
Is that
30? 30. Yeah. Alright, so it's very, very close for the top spot between Manish and Kokul, and of course for the second spot also it is open. So Kinshuk, brilliant answer for the last one. Next question to Aditya. The last question of this quiz. Aditya, your question coming up. Connect. This is for Aditya. Aditya, need an answer?
No.
Okay, Gokul? Yeah, Gokul, you're on mute.
Yeah, I don't have anything. Since this is the sixth question and LeBron also was six, I'll just guess something to do with the number six.
Perfect, 10 points, absolutely hidden out of the park. This is 6, Jami was 6, LeBron was 6 for the Miami. This is six and out, the band. And so this is the Six Nations Championship. So well done, Gokul. I think over to Vishnu for the final scores.
Gokul tops with 55, and then comes Manish with 40. Then comes Venky and Kinshuk at 30, and then Sumanta at 20 and Aditya at 10.
All right, so well done. I think we don't need to do a tiebreaker. So Gokul wins. We'll reach out to you for the prizes. Joint third is Kinshuk and Venky, and Aditya and Sumantra finishes fifth and Aditya finishes sixth. So nice sixer to cap it off, Gokul. Very well done. Hope you all enjoyed this quiz as well as the prelims. And we wish you all a Merry Christmas, a belated Merry Christmas, and a very Happy New Year in advance.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Very nice quiz. Thank you so much.
Very nice quiz. Nice test.
Congrats, Gokul, Manish. Bye.